Hello, masterclass members. I became a new subject that will enhance your ability to diagnose pain. I am a rare pain physician who majored in radiology. Radiology was a shame in the trigger point injection era in pain management, but the knowledge of radiology became practical to judge the pain generators and predict the outcomes. So, I will share my clinical radiologic knowledge with you. Sometimes, it will differ from the image diagnosis of authentic radiology. She visited me for left shoulder pain. She is 59 years old. The pain started 1 year ago but was aggravated 3 to 4 months ago. She visited orthopedic doctors and received extracorporeal treatment and 1 injection therapy before me. But the pain did not improve. I conducted a simple physical examination in my clinic. The passive shoulder movement test showed a capsular limitation of the glenohumeral joint. Passive abduction, 80 degrees. Passive external rotation, 80 degrees. Back internal rotation, L4. It is my assumption. She had underlying basic pathology that she could bear the pain for 1 year. And a new pathologic process was added 4 months ago and progressed further that she could not resist. So, I will find the underlying pathology and new pain generator that bothered her most for the past few months. The simple X-ray shows bony spur formation on the upper lateral edge of the greater tubercle with sclerosis. The acromial lat tip is downward projected, and I assumed there was a chronic subacromial impingement and rotator cuff injury. Let me explain the ultrasound image. It is a tendon of the long head of the biceps, axial and sagittal scan. It is normal. A longitudinal scan of the subscapularis shows moderate degeneration with heterogeneous echogenicity. It is a short axis scan of the subscapularis. It doesn't have a related symptom to the capsular limitation. The longitudinal scan of the supraspinatus tendon shows an insertional degenerative tear, volume loss with surface depression, delamination of the tendon, cortical irregularity of footprint, and subdeltoid bursal effusion. A short axis scan of the supraspinatus shows heterogeneous low echogenicity. A longitudinal scan shows infraspinatus tendon and muscle, but there is prominent joint effusion. My ultrasound diagnosis is the supraspinatus insertional tear with delamination, subdeltoid effusion, and chronic subacromial impingement and bursitis. As I know, these pathologies can explain abduction, internal rotation limitation and pain, not external rotation limitation. There is no clue about the capsular limitation of the glenohumeral joint. I underwent an MRI scan of her shoulder. Coronal T2 weighted image shows the diffuse high signal intensity of the supraspinatus tendon, low echoic marginal spur formation on the edge of the greater tubercle. The spur formation is due to the chronic impingement between the greater tubercle and a lateral edge of the acromion. But the bony spur protected the supraspinatus tendon's further damage. But there is delamination and mild bursal side tear. While I move the image to the front, I can find a moderate subacromial effusion and high signal intensity around the biceps tendon if you follow the point to the inferior joint capsule. In addition, you will notice that the glenoidal side of the inferior capsule becomes high signal intensity compared to the scapular side. I want to show a sagittal T2 weighted image. There is a high signal intensity zone between the posterior inferior of the acromion to the 12 o'clock position of the glenoid of the scapular bone. The high signal zone position is in the rotator cuff interval, some part of the coracohumeral ligament. When I pull back to the lateral aspect of the scan, there is a high signal intensity in the anterior capsule of the glenohumeral joint, subchondral bone marrow of the humerus, and anterior inferior joint capsule of the humerus. Let me show the axial T2 weight image. Acromial fluid distension. There is a high signal intensity in the anterior capsule of the glenohumeral joint, subchondral bone marrow of the humerus, high signal intensity in the humeral side of the inferior capsule. Let me move up the scanned image, and the high signal intensity lesion corresponds to the coracohumeral ligament. It is my conclusion. The patient suffered from chronic subacromial impingement and mild rotator cuff tear for a long time. However, she could bear the pain because it was long-standing chronic low-grade pain, and she could avoid pain if she did not elevate the arm. But recently, the pain has worsened because of the adhesive capsulitis. In addition, there is an inflammation in the coracohumeral ligament, anterior capsule close to the humerus head, and inferior capsule. She cannot resist the pain because the inflammation is severe and strong enough to provoke subacromial bursitis. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.